Okay, so I went and grabbed some batteries. We got our destructions. Oh boy. Make sure these are off. I'm using Samsung 25Rs, but they're just 18650 batteries. Not putting the covers on just yet. Let me double check one thing real quick. Plug it in, turn the batteries on. And press S1 and S2. Okay, now we don't have the LEDs plugged in. So it says turn them on. Well, the Pi should have a red light and then a green light when it starts booting up. I don't know what the other board does. Nope. That's for the Pi. That's the board. We got two green lights for the board. Red light for the Pi. There goes the boot. So it's loading everything that I already loaded into it from chapter 1. The Pi 3B Plus is not the fastest. It's not. So we'll give it a minute or two before we even try to connect to the VNC. Don't see any smoke. I don't see any sizzles. Alright, so the boot light went out, so the Pi should be ready. Let's see if we can connect to the VNC. And as you can see, we're in the Raspberry Pi. And we're supposed to go to a terminal. Let's see if I can move this up here so you can see what's going on. So we'll go into a terminal. Give it a second to load. And then you can see that we have what they show here. I need to type all of this in. Copy this back to our viewer, paste, and then we should have what they have on the second line. And now we want to do the sudo Python server servos. Now the servos will rotate to certain angles. Please keep the program running when installing the servos. Okay, so I'm just going to kind of work with the thing here a little bit. So the wires in the front, the servo horn is this way. So this is left. And these would be right. checking, make sure I got these all lined up correctly. They do show the board upside down with the caps facing up, the servo gears facing up. And they do match. Okay. So those are the only ones we're plugging in. Oh, and then we're plugging O1 in. And the legs. Okay, well. Let me get the other servo out. See what we're doing here. And then the legs. See if it's up. Those are right, those are left. Okay, so top left, and this orientation is 23 and 22. 22 is this one. Wow, good luck reading that. Where's my magnifying glass? There's this one. So this one is 22. Good grief, could they made them any smaller? So I heard it move once. And then the leg for them. Apparently he had a lot to say. Well, isn't that fun? Okay, well, you guys can move back there out of the way. Can't do much of anything with you. The next set. So, the putting all the servos into neutral was a waste of time. What was this, 19? And 2021. Okay. First one in. Things get nice and snug in here, don't they? Would have started with the leg, but it specifically says to start with the others. Wire management is going to be a mess. Next one on this side will be 16, 17, and 18. I'm assuming that's this next set of three. Yes. Foot. Okay, left side is done. Oh no. Wait a minute. Potentially we may have the legs or the feet on backwards. These are the way the picture showed, so we're going with that. Alright, so you up here. Actually, let's start down here. So you would be first. One of the foots. Trust me, if you can't read little teeny tiny wires, letters, make sure you have a magnifying glass. Although I have found, you can take a picture with your cell phone and just zoom in. It'll work. Yeah, see, I'm going by these humps that they show corresponding to this on this side. So that's what we're doing. I think it's backwards, but worst case scenario is we can just flip them around. Making sure they're all seated. And I have no idea where these go. We'll have to mark these, I guess. 1 and 2, 1 and 0. We will put a, one on you. And a 0 on you. In case we have to unplug them when it's powered off to move things. So it really doesn't tell us. I'm gonna have to figure out where in the hell 0 and 1 are. I'm hoping they're up here towards the front. Let's see, ground, signal, servo. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. The other 5 servos you connect them, that's all the servos. 0, 1 in there. Okay, well, that's what we're gonna do. Everybody's connected, everybody rotated. Oh boy. Okay, so back to the screen. We got all the wires it's saying to connect them. What did they really say specifically? And then we go on to building. And I do know we do not hook a camera up to a Pi while it's powered on. So I think now that we have all the servos done, it should be laying out flat like this. Okay. Well, let's go with the instructions on the screen here. It says press Control C to end the program. Oh, as always, we see it. So we're done. Okay, so bash exit not there. Should be able to close. I think we can go ahead and power down too. I think we just shut it off. The viewers. Go back to the boards. Everything should be powered off. Okay. Power these off as well, if I knew how. I'm also going to unplug them. Just kind of get that out of our way for now. Oy-vey. So the legs have to be out flat when we install them. Means all this has to flip out there. Oh no, these would be the correct ones. Okay. It would be when you... It's all upside down at the moment. So we're going to flip it over, and we're going to put it together so everything is straight out. And then apparently we're going to put the little blue servos and the head together. Okay, we'll come back to that. So for now, we gotta put all these screws in. And you showed me on the other one here, putting these screws in. Alright, well, I'm not gonna make you watch me do all that. I'm gonna go ahead and pause you. I'll come back when I get the leg screwed on. Okay, so, ran into an issue. I show the main board with the pie towards the bottom, and the pins for the servos to plug into facing us. Servo homes are facing up. But then they show you the servos facing right side up. Because technically that's right, but it really made me misunderstand it. So I hooked everything up backwards without realizing it. Right is over here. This is the front, upside down. This is the right-hand side. This is the left-hand side. This is the front. This is the rear. Just keep that in mind when you do the servos. Lefts over here. Rights over here. And then put all the wiring and the screws in with them pointed just the way they show here, and then with the legs here so they're straight out. And again, they're showing these facing up when they really should be flipped over the other way. This is how it should look when you assemble it. This picture. Everything's face up, the feet curled down, right on the right, left on the left, and in this picture, the right is over here, it's facing you. Left is over here. This is the front, this is the back. So these should be curled down, the servos facing you with it. Left hand side should be curled down with the servos facing you while it's facing you. I hope that helps. Alright, so I am going to go back now and put these screws in. And then put these screws in with the arms, the legs, whatever you want to call it. And I'll be back. So again, never mind what your spidey senses are telling you. This is the front, this is the right. This is the left, this is the rear. Put it together accordingly. Right now I'm just putting the arms on. Legs, whatever. Got the back two on already. Just want to make sure I was oriented correctly. But I see now there might be an issue. Probably should have started at the front. And you're putting these metal into metal, but you still, you want them snug, but you don't want to break them. Make sure you put all the arms back where they belong. When you actually power it on the first time at least, so it knows where it's at. There are no sensors. When you first plugged it all in, you programmed it and told it where the straight out is, and that set all the servos to that, so when you assemble it they need to be all straight out. So when you first turn it on, it knows where it's at. And I've already been noticing this servo is weak. Barely touch it and it drops. Well, that one did too. Okay, fine. Never mind. They're all doing it. Alright, I'm going to get the rest of the legs on it, and then we'll be back. Alright, so we're on to the next step. Got all the legs in. I'll show you here in a minute. Now servo 1, that's the one we wrote the number 1 on, goes into this little flat piece, and we connect it to the longer piece that servo 0 goes in. Let's get those put together and then we'll get to the faceplate. Let's get this here done first. So here's what I did so far. Now this is the front. Now these kind of sag down, but we'll put it on a flat surface when we first turn it on. So we need this servo 1. Which is this one. Okay. And it goes... Yep, goes like this. I actually already have the bolts and the nuts out. Those are really long. Wow. That actually makes it more difficult. I don't know why these bolts have to be half an inch long when they're only going like an eighth inch, but you know, don't snug them down until you get both sides in. And you can see how much longer than they need to be, but they are. Well, of course you can see my arm now. Grief, can't pick that thing up. Right there, that's all the longer they needed to be. But it is what it is. So now we have them both in there. Let's see if we can get it tight. That would be a new. There's not any possible way of using that. Because the bolt's too long. Shows putting this piece right in the pretty side. Goes in here. Oh, and it catches the nut, so I don't have to worry about that. And then this goes in here. You want to stop just before it gets into that gap. Grab the nut, drop it in. It should thread right into it. Now this one, because it's up against the acrylic, will tighten up. And it did. It's actually a pretty neat little design they have. That and this one goes there. But anyway. Servo 0, which we grabbed out of the bag, goes in this orientation. He doesn't have a screw, it's in his bag. They don't show any of the wires in the tutorial or the instructions, so you have to double check everything. It would really be a pain in the butt to have to take it apart just to flip it over. I do plan on disassembling part of it, just because I did not realize how they set the servos. But I definitely want to clean up those wires. I don't want all those wires hanging down. Yes, we got a wire cover, but still, I mean, we got like 2 inches of extra wire here that's just not needed. But before I do any of that, make sure it all works, of course. Make sure we got full range of motion. It might end up using that when it lifts the leg or curls or whatever the case may be. So I want to double check all that before I do any modifications. Who knows, I might be able to wire tie it all up underneath and make it look good without actually physically shortening anything. Alright, so those are all together. Now there's something about the faceplate. And what goes in him is the camera. And the sensor. And we have all that fun cabling to hide stuff. Their little flimsy screwdriver that they sent me. Of course, the one I'm using. A little bit bigger handle. These, they break too easy and they strip out and they strip screws and it just doesn't make for a fun day. So, this goes here, obviously. See any screws or anything. Ribbon cable for the camera. And the camera itself, way down in here. I'll say they definitely protected it. We have a little cover over the lens as well. Can they bolt to this? Yeah, I bet that's how it goes. They bolt to this piece. Let's double check those instructions. So, screws in there with the four little 1/4.5s, same thing with the camera, looks like they both take four screws each, and then two nuts from there, actually it only shows one, but I know there's one on both sides, no. The other side gets screwed into a servo horn. Where did this piece come from? Okay, this piece here. We have two of them. Yeah, that's the piece they're referring to. no instructions whatsoever on this. But we can deduce from the picture that servo home goes on there, and two screws from the servo package, and then the M216 nut goes through all of it, holds it on. Interesting, but okay. And then just one there. Wow. So M2 nut here, just through the two pieces of acrylic, and then an M nut and bolt through this to hold all three together. And the third piece having the servo horn that will then screw into the servo package we just built, and then that will screw into the top of this facing forward. Alright, so I'm going to get these screwed on, get this put together, get this put together, get that put together. We're going to put it on the main part of the body. We'll be back. Alright, so we got this done. We're ready to attach his head. This. Really cool idea. Those little M2 nuts suck. I'm going to attach his head. I did put the wires in here, just so they were there. Still doesn't show that one being connected, but I did do that. Oh, there it shows it being done. But you can see I got him all together. So this screw goes all the way through and into this. Locks this into that. That little screw, that's a pain in the butt. This one just sticks out long. Servos you saw me put together. Got the camera, the sonar, the wiring in there, and then attached him here. So now we're ready to put him on. Hopefully we have everything right. I know the wires are a mess. These should have ran through these holes. But I think while it's off, you can unhook them. I wouldn't think it'd be any different than an RC car. While it's off, you can unhook the wires and reroute them. Just don't forget where they go. The thing I found with these inexpensive horns, don't like to go into them. Of course, just as I said that, it went right in. Now I need to tilt him back. Okay. And this. I have no idea how to route it. These all go to the bottom. side. Oh, and of course there's two of them. One says trigger, echo, the other sign has SDA and SCL. Pretty sure we want trigger and echo. Apparently this board can do a lot more. No idea what that was. It was a silver screw. It used to go in there. How did that happen? None of these screws are magnetizable, magnetic, ferrite. Alright. Get your arms and your legs back where they belong. Still do the top. I'm assuming this. It hasn't told us to do that yet. I'm assuming this is a spare. And then of course we have all the wiring, and then we still have the batteries. Probably come in from the bottom. Let's go check the instructions. Okay, so we got that plugged in. Yep, I knew it was trigger and echo. Now the base plate comes in from the bottom with M312s. Top plate goes on with M312s. Wow. Apparently, that's it. Then we'll do the test. Yeah, I guess it's just a bunch of bolts. M312s went somewhere. Ah, here they are. I'm going to dump them all out because we're going to use most of them. If I can pick them up. sure really what to do with this cable. I almost want to go down through one of these vents. Actually, like directly under it, so in front of it or behind it wouldn't make much difference. So now, the wiring, obviously, is still an issue. But the top part of this is done. Just need to put this on the bottom. I'll put the plates on it now. On off buttons are still here. Mess of wires in here. Okay. See if it says anything about. No, didn't say anything. So we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 3, 4, 5, 6. I actually have some screws, a few nuts left over. Oh, this has to screw. Plug these in first. I think it fits between them. Oh, I bet those are supposed to go in those holes. I think. So they didn't say anything about that in the instructions. But yes, that does clip in there. Oh. Alright, so we gotta squeeze it together, flip it over, and put the screws in it. Easier said than done. I think we managed it. Clearly, we did not. You can't even put this screw in here with this on. These two don't even line up. I wonder if there's a front and a back. Yeah, there's nothing in the instructions about this. Yeah. The three bigger holes go back here, the three little holes go up there. Now they fit the holes. Make sure the wires are getting pinched. And they can freely move. Just get them all started for now. The front one, I'm gonna have to take that off. Also, before we tighten them up, I think we should make sure the bottom stayed lined up. Those little pieces from the hip shoulders fit down in a groove on that bottom tray. Didn't see that in the instructions anywhere. I mean, yes, it's pretty obvious, but didn't see it in the instructions. I wonder what the hole back here was for. I thought maybe they'd modified the LEDs. Alright, so let's take a quick look. We still have the one in the front to do. All those are still in there. Obviously, I still have to tighten them up. I'll make sure there's no wires getting pinched. No, this is not how this wiring is going to be. This kind of sprung on me. Alright, well, I think we can tighten it up. Snug it up. I'm not going to tighten these, per se. Because I am going to be taking this apart. And cleaning up the wires. I think this should have been done a long time ago to help support the arms. Still have the LEDs unplugged. Obviously they haven't gotten back to me in the last few minutes. So because there's one screw right there. Can't get to it with the head on. Take all these spare bits. This came with it. Still got to do all this. But as far as the gist of it goes, it's done. It's supposed to be. No, it's supposed to be straight up or down. I don't know. We're gonna go down. I guess. I mean, it doesn't say. And I think I'm gonna get all this off the table because I think if it moves and stands up, it's gonna want the table. clear off some of my mess. These should be in there. Double check the instructions though. Okay, so basically, looks like we're ready to turn it on. We're gonna make it move. I hope. So let's go ahead and end this one here, and we'll just make that the next one that I do.